Anytime I feel that I'm not happy, I know I'm in ego-based consciousness, right? Separateness. When we call it separate, so anything that creates a corrosion, an interference, or a separateness between us, that's the definition of ego. Fear. A lot of athletes think fear motivates. Fear cannot motivate you. It's an ego. It's like the core of the ego. Fear is the core of the ego. It's the biggest depreciator of energy. Why? Because it corrodes this connection and it corrodes this connection.
Then the most complex thing to understand is the law of surrender, because everybody doesn't get the fact that this fear, you know, false evidence appearing real, this illusion, that's all it is an illusion. I always tell people, would you be upset? Like if you knew your life was a video game, you would not be upset when you learned a lesson. You wouldn't say, oh, I'm an idiot. Oh, like, because you just press the button again and start over. Well, that's literally what you can do in your real life. But you don't take that perspective. We start beating ourselves up.
That's crazy.
Start beating ourselves up.
That's crazy.
I don't know why. Right? We start going and putting faith in the wrong things. Anxiety is the spiritual display of you not getting it. Like, if you're anxious, you're out of alignment. You have a void, a shortage, an obstacle, resistance. You're working against yourself. Anytime that you have anxiety about making money, raising money, executing on what it is, you are literally not putting your faith into acceleration and exponential growth. You're actually working against yourself. You're putting a weight in your backpack compared to what I'm doing.
And I have anxiety of like certain things, and I fear of the future. I work harder and I'll get more result. And I'll be like, cause I'm like running, I'm on a rat race, and I'm—
Cause you don't think there's enough. So it is motivating. If you don't think there's enough, if you live in a universe of scarcity, then anxiety is going to motivate you. The difficult thing about it is it's draining you at the same time. See, the difference between me and most people is I'm twice as old as most people that are watching me, but I have more energy and inspiration than they have, and I'm happier than they are. And I'll tell you why, because I'm not motivated by anxiety anymore. Me, I'm practicing staying focused when I don't have fear.
If inspiration is our goal, if when we're inspired, we can bend time, when we're inspired, we're happy. We're in spirit, we're connected to that which has inspired us, we're in the flow. When we're on a direct trajectory towards our potential or our truth, we're inspired. What happens? We get afraid. Our ego gets in the way. Number one, in order to stay in the quantum state, the mindfulness that you need to be in a state of abundance where there's more than enough, you have to know your ego. And in order to know your ego, you have to define it. I define mine in a multitude of ways, but number one is the need to be separate, inferior or superior, the need to be right, the need to be offended, the need to be guilty, the need to attack, the need to be frustrated, the need to be scared, the need to be anxious. And so what I do is when I'm not feeling good, if I'm not feeling inspired, I know the ego edging goodness out of my life is corroding my connection, because I know I'm always connected. It's just corroding my connection to that which inspires me. So what do? I stop. Whatever mechanism you want to know, but think about the analogy. What do people do? They're going on the drive and they're supposed to be going down to San Diego on the 5 South, and somehow something happens that pisses them off or scares them, or life happens in some direction. They're tired, hungry, or other emotions that are there, and all of a sudden they turn off of their trajectory onto the 5 North. But emotions are wicked. They're not like a car. Emotions love to accelerate and grow. So what do we do when we're off? We put on the gas, right? We put on the gas when we're angry. We put on the gas when we're guilty and resentful, when we're inferior and superior. We put on the gas, and then we end up in San Francisco wondering how we got there when we wanted to be in San Diego. And oh my God, my life is over. Do you know why I stand on stages? It's not for money. Look at anything I do, any video I do, any speech I give, I give away my books and pay for shipping. It's not for money. You know why I do it? Because the number one cause of death of people under 50 is suicide. Are you kidding me? People taking their own lives because they're not happy. Because they don't understand, just stop. Right? Take a deep breath, live in inspiration. All you gotta do is take a step back, stop, ask for help. Which way am I supposed to go? You've been down to San Diego before. You're someone sitting in the situation I need. Stop. Breathe. You don't have to be a master meditator. You don't have to be Zen. You don't even have to be woo-woo. You simply got to stop and ask for help.